We have the body of a woman, an arch over the ground, and there is no danger. Her hair falls, spine bowed, and no one is with her. The desert, yes, with its cacti, bursage, sidewinders. She is not in danger. If we notice, there are the tracks of animals moving east toward the sunrise. And the light is about to touch a woman's body without possession. Here, there are no girl's bones in the earth marked with violence. A cholla blooms just 2 feet away. It blooms. There is a man who wakes to a note saying, "I have gone for a day into the desert." Now he knows she is in danger. He will anticipate what can happen to a young woman, how it will happen, how he will deal with the terrible. In him, he feels he knows this somehow. He knows because there are men he knows who are capable. This place she has gone to, where? But it doesn't matter. There is, first of all, the heat which scorches, snakes with their coils and open mouths. Men who go there with the very thing in mind, the very thing. It is the desert on its own, miles beyond what anyone can see, not peaceful nor vengeful. It does not bow down. It is not danger. I cannot speak of it without easing or troubling myself. It is not panorama nor theater. I don't know. It is conception, the gifts or burdens I bear, whether arch, a prayer, or danger. These things can happen. Yes, we conceive them. This very woman I know, the man does sit tortured. The desert, created, merely embodies its place and watches layer visions, O God, upon it.